Hi, my name is Kat, and I work really closely with the engineering team here at Ground Labs. Today we are excited to announce the latest release of Enterprise Recon version 2.0.28. In this release, we've introduced various security improvements and a brand new user permissions framework. We've also improved scanning for Amazon S3, SharePoint, and Microsoft SQL databases. Plus, we've introduced various new data types in addition to our usual bug fixes.
So Microsoft SharePoint is a platform that's widely used among our customers for storing structured and unstructured data. A lot of this data is actually sensitive, so you'll find things like GDPR sensitive data, PCI data, HIPAA data. Finding this data inside of SharePoint is actually hard to do, and that's why it's one of our most popular features in Enterprise Recon. For the 2.8 release, we've enhanced our SharePoint support for large on-prem deployments. We've improved the reporting to make it much more business-centric. We've improved the way that credentials are managed to allow operators to essentially more effectively manage multiple sites. At the same time, we've simplified the setup overall. In addition to that, we've also rewritten the feature to go with the direct database approach. This has resulted in significant performance gains for the implementation overall. And of course, SharePoint Online for Office 365 remains supported for deployments of any size.
So one of the more significant updates in this 2.8 release is an entirely new permissions framework for Enterprise Recon. In previous versions of Enterprise Recon, there was basically a three-tier permission structure. So you had administrators, you had people who could scan or do reporting, and then you had reporting only users that could only look at some of the reports at either a detailed or summarized level. In 2.8, we've completely replaced that framework with an entirely new granular permissions approach. So it will let you go ahead and set up different levels of administrators. You can also set up different levels of users. A scenario that we were commonly asked about, which this new permissions framework addresses, is the ability to take a very large file store, like a large file server or a NAS or a very large SAN, which might appear as one object or one entity on your network, but it has petabytes or terabytes of storage. And you can now split that up into different permissions groups. So you could, for example, take one folder that exists under a large share, and that one folder belongs to Department A. And so you can set up the permissions framework in Enterprise Recon so that only users of that department can see Department A's files and folders relating to what they do. And then likewise, Department B can only see what they're doing, and they can't see Department A's information. And there's also some remediation controls, some more granular remediation controls. So now you can set up a level of remediation for an individual user that says they can only look at the finding and confirm if it's real and if we can do something about it or not, but they can't actually do anything destructive to it. And a different user, perhaps the department team leader or someone else, has the ability to come on and actually do a destructive remediation action on an object, on a file or an email, for example, in accordance with the permissions that they've been given. So all in all, a huge step forward for Enterprise Recon and far more power that users have been asking for.
In this release, we have enhanced our security complexity requirements, which also includes limiting our logons and more on the generic password complexity requirements. We have also introduced a login banner whereby the organizations can set up a welcome message or terms and conditions before the employees can log in into the web console.
Support for new databases is one of our most commonly requested features, and in this release, we have formalized support for MariaDB, which previously would require an unsupported workaround when we needed to scan MariaDB. So in 2.0.28 release for Enterprise Recon, you will now be able to see MariaDB as a selectable option from our list of officially supported databases. So you can easily click and select MariaDB when you're configuring a new scan to look for sensitive data. So this brings our total number of supported databases to date to 10.
In version 2.8, we've added a new data store backend that improves performance. We can handle a larger number of connected agents. We can concurrently process more reports and deal with much larger data sets. In addition, the new data store backend is highly fault tolerant. What that means is that if there's an unexpected power outage or something happens to the server, the data store should be completely uncorrupted and would come up just fine. We've also updated the base operating system to CentOS 7. This gives us access to a longer support and maintenance period up until the year 2024. It contains the latest security updates and performance improvements to the base operating system, and has a much nicer graphical installer that should help with the installation process.
In this release, we'll be adding a beta feature which allows us to scan sensitive data within MongoDB databases. We have also added a beta feature which allows you to scan Dropbox enterprise domains for sensitive data. If you'd like to access these beta features, please contact our support staff for further instructions.
So the information about the people's race or ethnicity may be considered very, very sensitive for certain organizations. We identified over 400 different data points related to such information, and we introduced a new data type that lets you find basically those kind of data, ethnicity, race, heritage in your systems. We have also added new data types to help customers looking for Romanian or South Korean confidential details. For Romania, we added national identification card number, and for South Korea, we added corporate registration number. We have also improved detection of South Africa identification number and South Korea passport number.
In addition to what we mentioned earlier, we have over 50 minor improvements, updates, and fixes. So, if you currently hold an Enterprise Recon subscription, you can update the installation right now. Instructions on how to do that are in the video description. As always, if you need any help, our support team is available 24 hours a day, Monday to Friday. Thank you for your support, and we look forward to telling you all about our new release in early 2019.